it's nice to see you girls getting along in my absence.
What's going on?
Oh, nothing, Vera.
Why, what did you expect? Blood and guts.
I thought you were desperate to come back and get to work.
Just getting my bearings.
It takes a while to get acquainted after you've been away for a couple of weeks.
Is she back for good or what?
Worries you, does it?
Not specially. Just curious to know what she's done to deserve it.
Maybe it's what you've done, Gilmore.
You mean you've got your watchdog out?
We've been set up.
Are you losing your nerve, Latham? That's a good idea. I'd hate to have to put you on report.
Thanks, Vera. Nice of you to help me with the workers. Geez, it's quiet in here. G'day, Jude. Here, you want a game?
Yeah. I'll play.
Oh! Oh!
Oh, crap! That's enough of that, Smith.
Oh, hell it is! No one can swing at me and get away with it.
I say that's enough. I'll handle her. But it looks like you'll be joining your friend in solitary, Bryant.
Yeah. It does, doesn't it?
Well, it's Bryant I'm interested in.
Well, she only bashed you so she could get near Sharon.
Well, if she wants to play games, I've got a few I could teach her.
Well, g'day.
Oh, no, you don't. There's one thing you've got to learn about me, Bryant. I don't like being hit in the face when I'm not looking. Now, this may not be a public affair, but there never was one for example. Oh, just get away from me. Do you understand?
You should have finished this ages ago, Smith.
Well, if a job's worth doing properly.
How did this happen to you, Bryant?
It was an accident.
Leaky pipes.
Ladies, I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Pierce.
Oh, the name's Ken, please.
Oh, Ken. Well, Ken and his drama group are performing the play for you tonight.
Doesn't look like
Ken,
a theory
to
me.
Like to how would you know? Things, show them where you want things.
Okay, well, first of all, ladies, could we get rid of some of these tables, please?
Yes, Beth, what is it?
All the tables?
Well, the more space we have.
And what are we going to do about the refreshments afterwards? Eat them off the floor?
Of course, refreshments. After more than 20 years in jail, I should have realised. You look after your bed, your body, and your ablutions, right? And the rest can take care of themselves. What's your name?
B. Smith.
And is that a name or an initial?
Name. B-E-A.
Do you mind if I call you that?
Do you like?
Fine. Oh, and thanks for reminding me about my priorities.
Did I ever tell you about Marilyn and Eddie?
No.
Well, Marilyn was a pro. Used to be in and out of Wentworth every couple of months. And Eddie was an electrician, used to work here. Well, they took a fancy to each other.
I still don't get you.
Well, things got so hot in here, finally they had to do something. And they found this attic.
In Wentworth?
Yeah. Mind you, that's going back a bit. But I think I might just have to put that attic back to work.
You haven't got the hots for Fletch, have you?
No, dear. Ken Pierce.
Oh, when I think of the number of times I spent in that pound. You know, I used to read aloud just so I could remember the sound of my own voice.
Well, at least you got out with an education.
Well, it didn't help me to relate to people. You have to have someone who understands to do that.
Well, what about family or friends?
When you're in and out of prison for 20 years, you lose them all.
Yeah. I think the only people I know on the outside are the ones I've met in here.
You ever been married?
Yeah, when I was 17.
Didn't she stand by you?
Well, a year after we got married, I got 5. And I figured I should bust out and look after her. Look after her. 2 days later, I got busted for armed robbery, cop 20 years. Haven't seen her since.
Do you ever figure on getting caught?
Now I would, yeah, but not then. When I was 18, I reckon I was untouchable.
Yeah, you know, I knew I'd be caught. And I thought it was worth it.
And now?
I'd do it again. How do you think you'll go rehabilitating me?
I reckon it's worth a try.
Why don't you pick on someone else for a change?
Just for that, you're going to get 2 weeks in the pound, Gilmore. For being selfish and such a pain in the backside!
Little baby!
The governor warned you about there being trouble. I'm sure she's going to be very pleased to hear about this. You see that Mr. Pierce has shown out? I told you your little lot would bring an end to this nonsense.
You little bitch!
Billy, it's not worth it.
It's worth it to me. G'day, bitch.
Bee,
talk about ungrateful. They're all set to bring the magic of drama and theatre into our lives, and you go and bugger it up. The trouble with you, Gilmore, is you don't know how to act. And you're going to have to be taught.
No one wanted it anyway.
I wouldn't say that.
You wanted it, all right. It was the only way you could get your hands on that smart-ass crim who was running...
Smith, you're wanted in the governor's office. Now!
Why would Mrs. Davidson want to see?
Well, that's easy. To tell me it's no go with the drama group. As if I didn't know that.
So that's it, Smith. The drama group will continue, and you will do your utmost to make it work.
Well, that's a turn-up. I thought you put a stop to
it. I know what you thought, and as usual, you were wrong. So far, you have wrecked every attempt at rehabilitation, but not this time. Now, are you going to cooperate or not?
What? Oh, yeah, of course, whatever you say.
I don't want another shambles like last time. Can you guarantee that?
Absolutely.
Very well, that is all. You will be told when the drama classes resume. In the meantime, I suggest you have a long, hard talk with your thespian friends.
Well, no doubt B. Smith has already told you that the governor wants us to go ahead with this drama project. So Ken Pierce will be visiting us on a regular basis to supervise. Ken, would you like to...
I'd like to go on to a play reading to get some idea of what you can all do. Paul's got hold of this play for us, and I'd like you to each choose a character. And then we can give it a burl.
A Midsummer Night's Dream? You have got to be joking.
I did this when I was a nipper at school.
Bee, could you get the women to read through the play and then write down anything they don't understand?
Oh, yeah. I could do that for you.
Good.
Bet you'd like to get him in the storeroom for 10 minutes.
Yeah, and I'll bet if he forced himself on you, you wouldn't even scream.
Not until afterwards, anyhow.
This is supposed to be an exercise period. That doesn't mean exercising your mouths.
Bitch.
If her ears were any bigger, I reckon she'd take off in a headwind.
Mm.
Hey, Bay, here he comes.
Hi, Annie. What have you been up to, eh? Mm-hmm.
I wonder why older men always go after younger women.
What you need's a good man, Pat. It does wonders for you. I mean, look at Bea over there. It's done wonders for her.
You shut your mouth, Gilmore. And what would you know about a man?
Oh, no, we have got our knickers in a knot. Maybe we need to put a little drama back into our lives.
Any more smart-ass comments out of you and I'll ram those teeth of yours right down your throat. And that goes for the rest of you. Do you hear? I don't want any more cracks about the drama group. Got it?
I don't know what you're on about. All I've
got said... it?
I'm told that you have a secret admirer here. B. Smith. Obviously, she saw you meeting your daughter, thought that your daughter was somebody else, and she's been trying to put a stop to the drama group ever since. A woman scorned, all that sort of thing.
I see. Yeah.
Anyway, that's why I asked you to come here. I need your help. I know it's a hell of an imposition, but...
Oh, no worries, Paul. I understand.
Good.
You asked to see me?
Yes, Bee. You know Ken, of course. We wanted to talk about the drama group.
I told you before it had nothing to do with me.
Mm. Yeah, well, there are a couple of people I have to see first. I'll be back in a few minutes.
You haven't left Smith alone with Pierce.
Yeah, well, it's perfectly all right, I can assure you.
It's against regulations.
What's this I hear about trouble with a drama group?
Oh, well, you know what women are like.
Can it be fixed?
Not by me, it can't. I've got other things to do.
Well, so have I, B. You know, I don't see my daughter nearly as much as I should do. Debbie be the first one to tell you that. Do you know she had to meet me here after our last meeting? Because I haven't seen her for days.
Your daughter?
Yeah.
Oh.
So you see, I really don't have much time to waste on groups that aren't interested.
Well, it's probably just a phase. I wouldn't be surprised if they wanted to get back to it already.
That's up to them.
Yeah. I'll have a chat with them and see what they think.
Good.
How's Debbie?
Oh, I don't know, Bea. It's funny meeting your daughter for the first time after all these years.
Mm.
I just don't know her. She's a stranger. You know, she didn't even come home last night, and you want to see that crowd she hangs out with.
Well, that's easily fixed. Give her a good clip around the ear. It's not as if she's too old.
Yeah, but I am. I should have been with her when she needed me 15 years ago.
Oh, well, you couldn't help that.
I could have kept her out of trouble. We both could.
Well, at least you got a second chance. Oh, bloody kids, they're nothing but trouble. You should let me have a word with her. I'd soon straighten her out.
I doubt that. You'd be a hero, you know that? Sometimes I think that's her only ambition. Be top dog in a place like this.
A day in here would soon change her mind.
Yes. Yes, it might.
Good day, Mr. Bennett.
Has Birdsworth been in here?
Beg pardon?
Birdsworth. Has she been in here?
No, no one's been in since I arrived. Oh, Miss Bennett. Is Mrs. Davidson in her office?
Yes.
Do you think I could see her, please?
I'll ask her.
Don't you think I'd better come with you? That way you can keep an eye on me.
Yes, that might be better.
Could I have your attention, please? Smith, I believe Mr. Pierce has spoken to you about his daughter.
Yes, right.
Well, tomorrow morning she'll be coming in here as part of a crime prevention program and spending a day as an inmate.
What's she gone and done, Mrs. Davidson?
Nothing yet. That's the whole idea. It simply means that the staff, and one hopes, the inmates, will be able to convince this girl that a life of crime is neither exciting nor rewarding.
Oh, so you want us to straighten her out, right?
That is correct, Smith.
And kids your age think, oh, it's never going to happen to them.
You smirk all aboard just once more, sweetie. And next time, that'll be something heavier. You think this is a game? Well, I'll tell you a few things. You are headed the right way to end up in here. And when you do, I am going to be waiting for you. And you won't think it's so funny then. Because you'll do what I say when I say. And if you so much as prick your nose without asking me, I will cut your stupid throat. You see, I've got nothing to lose. There's nothing more they can do to me. Have a look at Doreen and Lizzie.
I said look at them! They're worth 10 of you!
If they screw themselves up and end up in here because they had no one to straighten them out about a few facts. So I am doing you a favour. Now I'll tell you a few things about this place. There was a kid your age that hung herself in her cell. Another one went off her head because they took her baby away from her. Then there was the one that was so scared she hid in a dryer and suffocated. You see, it breaks you. It ruins your life. But then you wouldn't care about that, would you? You know it all.
How can you say that about them? Well, they think you're the greatest.
Oh, yeah, I'm terrific.
Well, you are, too. And I'm going to tell my dad you're sweet on him.
You keep out of it. You know nothing about me, what I think or feel.
Well, the way you talk about him, you must like him a little bit. Anyhow, I reckon you'd smarten him up real quick. You might even get together when you get out of here. I wouldn't mind.
When I get out of here? When I get out of here, I'm going to be 50 years old. Can you see any man waiting that long? Time means nothing to a kid your age.
Well, I'll tell you what it means to me. It means I am never going to have any more kids of my own. And I'm never going to have any grandchildren. It means the only thing I've got to look forward to is seeing your father once in a blue moon. Knowing that we can never even be alone together. Never touch. And knowing that we've got no future. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm tough. I run this place, all right. You know why? Because it gives me something to think about.
Because if I think about myself, it scares the living the hell out of me. And why should I be any different to any other woman? I want what they want. A home and a family. I want someone to care about. Oh, and I want someone to care about me. I'm not talking about love. I don't know what that means anymore. Just simple, bloody caring. But I've given that up. And that's what I've got to look forward to. A big, fat nothing. I am probably going to end up like Lizzie. Nowhere to go, and no one to turn to. Breaking my neck to get back into here. Because it's the only home I know. And the only place I feel safe. And that's what I've got to live with.
Look, B, I want to tell you how much I appreciate what you did for Debbie.
Oh, I didn't do much to help.
Oh, yes, you did. She's gone back home to her mother.
Well, it is what you wanted, isn't it? So why so gloomy?
Yeah, sure, yeah. Whatever you said to her certainly had a lasting impression.
Oh, yeah, I'm a great actor.
If it does work out the way you say, you've got a promise to come and live with us.
Get away. You don't want a silly old bugger like me living with you.
Oh, of course we do. You know what? We could do up your room just the way you like it, and then we could go shopping.
Listen, there's going to be some trouble in a minute, so when it happens, just go to the storeroom at once.
Right? What are you talking about?
Don't ask any questions, just do it, please. B'll explain everything to you later. Look, trust us.
I saw that, you old thief. Give him back.
I'd never took nothing.
Don't steal anything, Hunt.
It isn't me, it's her.
Oh, leave her alone.
Hush, your pencils.
Oh, there they are. I'll pick them up for you. Phil, they must have fallen off the chair.
Oh, thanks. Sorry, Lizzie.
Oh, that's all right, Phil.
Any more of this nonsense and we'll stop the classes altogether. Understand?
Okay, now, if everybody's ready, let's just get on with it, huh?
Where's Mr. Pierce?
Oh, I think he must have gone to get some more things, Miss Bennet.
Ladies, this gentleman is here as an observer. I trust you will remember there is a guest in the room.
Would you like to sit down?
Thank you.
Carry on.
Right, V, would you like to go and get changed?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, now V's going to be changing. She's going to be our model for us. But while she's changing, I'll just explain the pencils we're going to use, that sort of thing.
We wouldn't do anything to get you into strife, King.
You know, you women have got so much initiative. It's a wonder any of you ended up inside at all.
I feel such an idiot.
Why?
Because I'm a woman close on 40 and I'm hiding in a cupboard.
Well, that makes two of us.
Worst thing is that now we are alone together, I don't know what to say.
Do we have to say anything? It's just nice to know we're not being watched.
Yeah, I need to say something. Probably going to have to make do with these few minutes for the next 10 years. When you're on the outside, you think you've got all the time in the world to tell someone what you're feeling. After you've been inside for a while, you're lucky if you can remember what feeling means. Or if you do, how do you remember how to tell someone?
Do you know what I feel about you, B. Smith? You're a mixture of anger and fury and a lot of strength. You're a survivor. But you've still got a lot of softness and honesty and warmth. A woman like you is never going to know what it's like not to feel.
very lucky man even to have met you.
Dress, look, Lord, I think you should draw in the head first. Yeah, that's all right. Yeah, yeah. But to get the head right, you have to determine the whole body mass, right? That's the head in relation to the legs and the arms, etc. Give us a look. Yeah, well, that's all right. Actually, look, the shading there is terrific.
Mr. Kelly, I'm sure you've seen enough. The women have to get to work now. Could you see an officer outside?
Yes, well, I think I've got it all.
Thank you.
Most interesting.
You've been conned, Mr. Stewart.
Watch out, me!
Get out of there.
Miss Bennet, this is what
Save you it think. For the governor, Mr. Pierce. Although I'm sure she's not going to be too impressed with this sordid little affair.
He had nothing
Shut to up, do. Smith!
Come along, Mr. Pierce.
Hey, give that back to me, you bitch! Miss Bennet, stop her!
Will you put that down?
Hey, she's the one that lagged on you.
Get to your cell, Gilmore. You go with her, Bryant. We decide what punishment to give you. Anderson, you'd better get to your cell too. I think you've just had your last day working in the garden. Smith, Birdsworth, the rest of you get to work until the governor decides what punishment to give you. Not you, Vincent. I would have thought a woman of your age would have a little bit more dignity, Smith.
According to the record, it's fairly well established that you made threats on Gilmore's life.
Sure, but that's history. Anyhow, everyone threatened her at one time or another.
Quite. You have at least 10 more years to serve. 10 years without male companionship. That's a long time.
Oh, I don't know. All those flash schools are going co-ed. Maybe this joint will be next. A girl can dream.
Mr. Pierce certainly gave you something to dream about, didn't he? I don't know what happened between you two in that store cupboard, but I can guess. I bet he made some fairly tempting suggestions about what you might do to while away the next 10 years. And then to be exposed to all that ridicule and contempt. It must have been pretty humiliating to go through all that and have it all come to nothing. To have your dreams dashed because of Gilmore's spite. You certainly had enough motivation for killing her.
That bitch deserves all she got. But I didn't kill her.
Well, well. We certainly do have a temper, Mrs. Smith. Certainly enough to push someone down the stairs in a fit of rage.
I was in the laundry all the time.
Can you prove it?
There were half a dozen others there, they'll back me up.
Half a dozen women who wouldn't blow the whistle on their boss. Surely you can come up with a better alibi than that.
I'm a crim, Mr. Teagan. I'm meant to know every trick in the book. Now, don't you think if I killed Gilmore, I would have set up a better alibi?
Have you any idea why we're making a stand on this?
No.
Because I think like Judy does. A screw actually got away with murdering one of us. Now, I don't care if she's a no-hoper or not. No one. Not Davidson or the screws or the courts are going to shove this under a rug. And just in case you've all been listening to Vera too much, we're not animals, we're human beings. You spend enough time in this rat trap, though, and you start forgetting it. They try to treat us like zombies. So for the rest of your life, you think, if you can think at all, that you are just a piece of dirt. And you keep on getting swept right under that rug.
Well, well, Bert, on your hands and knees again, are you? Who are you crawling to this time?
What do you want?
Remember Doran and Lizzie? Mates of mine? Well, they have just taken the rap for you busting the storeroom cupboard.
Got to admit that lurker taking the packets from the bottom was a real brainwave.
Yeah, it was. But Doran and Lizzie still got sprung.
What's that got to do with me?
I want to know how Vera knew.
Knew what?
The fags were taken from the bottom cartons and they were in our cell.
Beats me. Pity about Doreen, but they reckon she'll be going to work in the factory after that.
You dirty lean bitch! Ah! I'll
never be born! Will you stop that?
Oh, isn't that Charlie?
Fighting again like animals. How disgusting.
It's one for you, Bee.
Oh, that's one for the books.
Oh, is there one there for me, Mrs. Jackson? There should be, thanks.
Oh, send her, Mr. Ken Pierce. I'll toss your foot. No need to get shirty.
Yeah, what did Ken say, Bee?
None of your business.
See what I mean? Plain bloody selfish.
You gonna write back to him?
Oh, I don't know. I can't write letters.
Yeah, but you could write to him.
I need to show myself up. He writes like he went to uni. You know how old I was when I left school? 15.
You gotta write to him, B. He'll be expecting to hear.
Yeah, just write like you talk. It'll come out okay, B.
Oh, what's the use? I can write my guts out, and he'd still be out there. Oh, I'd still be in here.
Dear Ken, it was really great to get your letter. It's the first real letter I've ever had in here. I didn't expect to be remembered, but I must say I rather like it. It sounded so much like you too. Straight from the shoulder and no bulldust. You're really going to have to forgive this note. I'm a bit out of practice after all these years. And I always did write like a camel waltzes. Nothing's changed. Well, it never does in here. But then why am I telling you that? I think I hate the winter most of all.
For once, Smith, you've proven that you can be responsible if you want to be. Perhaps you would like the opportunity of showing us you can be trusted.
Mrs. Davis.
I want Smith to set an example to the women. She's to be allowed on work release tomorrow.
You can count on me, Mrs. Davidson.
What are you going to do about Vince, B? They'll all get chucked out if you get caught.
They're always having accidents in factories. He's just going to have more than most. That's all.
Right, you're...
B. Smith, and you're Vince Talbot.
Yeah. You take this machine over here. You know how it works?
Looks pretty straightforward.
Okay, it's all yours. You do the same panels as Margot here.
Yeah, thanks.
Dory not here today?
No, I'm replacing her.
She sick or something?
No, the governor just decided to rotate things a bit and I said I'd like to have a go.
I'll give her my regards. Good little worker.
Yeah. And he's going to be sorry he ever heard of her. Bit dangerous, eh?
Yeah, I reckon.
Jackson?
Are you still not well, B?
Oh, manage. Me machine's packed up, though. It's running real ragged.
I'll get Mr. Talbot.
It's packed up, Mr. Talbot.
I can't see anything wrong.
Look, I'm really sorry. I mean, I don't even know what happened.
Well, it wasn't your fault. The wiring was frayed. Mm. Look, I think we'd better call it a day. It's nearly 3 o'clock and a fuse is blown anyway.
Either you are very stupid or you like to live dangerously.
Look, I helped you all at the factory, didn't I? And now I think I can help you again.
I wouldn't trust you if you're on your deathbed.
You've taken a sudden dislike to Vince Talbot. Why, what's he done?
It's none of your business.
Yeah. We hear you and him are good friends.
No, you got it all wrong. I can't stand him any more than you can, which is where I think I can help. I'll make a deal with you. You let me go my own way, and I'll hand you Talbot on a silver platter.
Ladies, we are going to get ourselves a bastard.
Get up back!
don't say you just fell over. Otherwise, you're going to find yourself inside for rape.
What do you want?
Settling in?
I won't be here that long.
Well, what a shame. We don't get many like you in here. And there aren't many who can wipe out our work release program with one hand and lose a 7 days remission with the other.
I gave you a choice. Pay up or I'd report you for attacking Vince Talbot.
Aren't you just a little bit nervous? I've seen people marked for life for less than you've done.
Are you threatening me?
Not really. Just putting you in the picture, that's all.
Yes, well, just don't make a move or I scream for the warders. They won't let you touch me. And you don't scare me either, you great fat cow.
Smith, what are you doing here?
She's throwing a weight around.
White, go and have your lunch. I'm warning you, Smith. The governor is in no mood for trouble.
I won't be here for that long. You'll be here long enough, you bitch.
No official details are available to date. However, unofficial sources claim that the drug haul could have a street value in excess of 200,000.
Oh, it's everywhere, isn't it? What do you think she'll get, B? 10? 20 years? You're the expert, aren't you?
I wouldn't have a clue, but she just better pray she doesn't end up in here. No, you get off my back.
I'm not on your back, dear. It's the chip on your shoulder.
All right, dear. You want to play funny buggers? Okay. Just so we know. Two can play at that.
Go on in. It's all right.
You look at that. A dope pusher being pushed in by a dope.
Knock it off, B.
Knock what off?
I'm not a dope pusher.
Will you leave her alone,
Dave? Don't tell me you fool them for that. I was set up, crap. They all say that.
Yeah, sure they do. But sometimes they're right, aren't they? You ought to know that. Your own daughter was...
You leave my daughter out of this.
Yeah, okay, I'll leave your daughter out of this, but you leave her alone.
All right, I'll leave her alone for now. But if any dope gets in here, I'll know who brought it in.
You won't know anything. You'll be guessing, and chances are you'll be wrong. Hi. You want to read something? Why don't you watch the telly?
Hey, you look, there's something wrong with Mouse.
What is it?
Well, she looks awful, wrong? And she's running around like nobody owns her. Better come and have a look at her.
Okay. Oh,
someone's going to pay for this.
Hello, B. Oh, what are you doing here?
Trying to get some of this stuff out of your system.
Oh, don't do that, B.
Come on, walk, will you?
I'm all right. Honest, I'm all right. You want to try some? Kay's got a whole bottle full of them.
Walk, buggy, you will you walk?
Oh,
Lizzie, you and Doreen get some black coffee and pour it in her throat, and if she throws it up, pour some more down.
Right, OB, come on, Doreen.
Okay, the rest of you, look, you're going to have to cover for Mouse. She's almost coming out of it now, but if the screws come in here, don't let them talk to her, whatever you do. Have you got that?
Yeah. What if they want to know what's wrong with her, Bea?
Oh, tell her she's had a dizzy spell, anything. Whatever you do, don't let them take her to the infirmary.
Right. Oh, sorry, Bea.
Yeah, Mouse, forget it.
No, really, I'm sorry, Bea.
Not half as sorry as the bitch who gave them to you is gonna be. I want you to pay particular attention to what happens in the next few minutes. Because you are going to learn what happens to dope pushers.
Tell me what you're looking for. Perhaps I can help you.
Doesn't matter. I've got all I need right here. I want you. Now, where would you like me to start, Miss White?
It's
about time you and me had a little private chat, Kay. Now, about this dope you've been spreading around.
What dope?
Let's not go through all that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then I'll give you a little hint. Mouse is floating around the ceiling somewhere.
So what's that got to do with me?
You put her there. Now, give me the rest of that stuff.
I haven't got any dope.
Bull, you haven't.
You won't get away with this.
The nurse should still be there. And you, move!
She asked for it!
Oh, really? Well, you can tell that to the governor.
Why, aren't you interested, Vera?
Going.
Well, Smith, what made you think that Kay White was selling drugs?
I heard it on the grapevine.
And who is buying? Oh, come on, Smith, you can't make an accusation like that without proof.
Answer the governor, Smith.
Oh, no. I don't dob in anyone who doesn't deserve it.
The whole thing's a pack of lies.
Look, she's got the stuff. I'm positive. She must have hidden it away somewhere before you searched.
She wouldn't have had time. Mrs. Jackson took her straight to the hospital. You have been waging a vendetta against this woman ever since she arrived. I'm sorry, Smith, but I just cannot accept your story without evidence to back it up. Very well. I am compelled to send you to solitary once more until the visiting justice decides what to do with you. Thank you, Miss Bennett.
Come on, Smith.
Where'd you hide it?
Shut up, Smith.
Where are those pills you put your filthy hands on? Well, maybe there weren't any. Maybe this was all a setup to get me out of the way.
Get a move on, Smith.
Either way, you are history, you bitch.